but I was raised like that. So I guess I never really changed like that. I be taking shots to the brain like that. Blacked out drunk and I came like that. Helping me to get through all the pain like that. Yeah, driving through the rain like that. Running from the fame like that. On the front page like that. Hey guys, so in the last video you've seen us building the rear coilover mounts in the back for the 300ZX cradle and stuff like that. In this video we're going to get started on mounting the radiator, which just came in this week. We've got an aluminium radiator. It's for a VZ LS1 Commodore, so we thought we'll use something that you can get readily available on the shelf. However, we will be modifying it, so you'll sort of you'll see that we've got to weld a few bungs on it for the mounting and stuff like that, which we haven't actually built yet or anything. I just know that that's probably what we'll need to do. So we're going to get stuck into that, and then we might even, depending on how we go for time this weekend, we might even get stuck into the front and start attacking the tube front on and stuff. So we don't know yet, but we will get the rear end, the radiator mounted, and have a look at where we're going to run the hard lines and braid line like that. So we've got some aluminium tubing that'll run the water lines up to the front of the car and plumb them into the motor. On the end of the aluminium tubes, we'll weld like a AN fitting to run braided line to the radiator, which we'll also weld some AN fittings onto the radiator. But anyway, so that came this week, so we can get stuck into that. Also this week, we've got the diff for it and drive shafts. It's just a standard setup for now, which will be fine. It's a 300ZX, so the longer drive shafts and a stronger diff. So we'll get that mounted in there, and then as the build progresses, we'll yank the center out and get it built up with a spool or two-way or whatever we decide to do there. And so that came in. Obviously, center wheels. Still looking killer, still absolutely wrapped with how they look. So yeah, for now I'm just gonna set the time lapse down and get stuck into cutting things up and bending some tube and stuff. These VZ radios are pretty good size, not a bad core. And a good size overall, but we'll be cutting back these fittings here. We'll cut these back a little bit and weld our AN fitting on there to run the braid and whatnot. And then we'll also weld on the brackets that we need to run the thermo fan assembly and stuff like that as well. And then this one also does have the ports for an automatic transmission for the cooler inside it, but we won't be running that, so that won't give us any grief. They're sort of blanked off and we'll just leave it like that for now. For our we're going to have separate coolers and stuff like that for our power steering and all that sort of stuff. Anyway, we'll set up separate coolers for that, so we're going to have a cooler for the engine as well, but those will be at the front of the car. So
don't mind if I do. It seems like every day I got a filled up phone. Ladies trying to text me saying that they home for the summer, and they heard that I'm living on my own. So they want to come to the crib, maybe cook me some supper, but I'm busy, so I'm ignoring her. Yeah, I just touched down in California. Now I'm headed to the beach, going swim in the water like I'm trying to sneak in across the border. I do all different types of crazy shit. I'm the youngin' host trying to make a baby with, cause it'll make them rich. No, I'm headed to the money, so these funny little girls want to take the trip. But no, only the MOST though with me. Other fools homo, Roy and Sig free. No disrespect though, I got addictive cigarette flow for the green pesto, presto.
So last night we got the radiator mounted, the mounts made up, and the radiator sort of sitting in place and fitted. It's not welded in place, or it's not completely welded, but we're going to wait till we weld out the rest of the rear end. But we've made the mounts up and I'm happy with the position it's sitting in. We didn't have to go overkill on the mounts because the radiator is relatively light for what it is. So mounts are only not overkill, basically. So today we're going to jump onto the front. We're not going to get a huge amount of hours in today. It's Sunday and I've got a bunch of work to do and things like that. So, but I'll get stuck into it for a couple of hours and hopefully we can cut a bit of the front end off. And we're just going to run like a tubular setup,
to hang the lights and the bar and the guards and things like that off. So yeah, we'll get stuck into that, and then down the track when the car starts to get a bit more assembled, then we'll start building a bash bar for the front and maybe the rear or whatnot. Not really sure yet, but for now we just want to get enough bar work in there that we can hang all the panels and things like that, so that we can then hopefully in another week or two we'll paint the front end and paint in the back and the cab and things like that. So anything that's I suppose staying. So the bars can wait till later, the bash bars and stuff like that can wait till later. But for now, anything that's gonna be somewhat structural or I suppose welded to the car, we wanna get that done sooner rather than later. So, but you can see we've got the radiator in and it looks good. Underneath it, we'll run some ducting from under the car to draw air through there, and then it'll exhaust out over the top. So the main focus at the moment is to get the fab work done. That's going to be, you know, part of the vehicle. That way we can get that done, get it painted, and then get it off the hoist until, you know, the next stage or whatever it might be. So, and then it's a matter of waiting on the drive line from Boost and Tune. When that comes in, we'll then bring it back in the shop, drop the drive line in, and then start doing the plumbing, brake lines, what else, tail shaft, things like that. So, you know, that'll give us a bit of a break in that period where we can start collecting those bits and pieces while it is off the hoist, because we are actually super busy with work at the moment with all this pandemic that's sort of been happening. We anticipated it'll be a little bit quieter, and that's why we may have time to work on the car. But in fact, it's completely opposite. Everyone seems to be bored at home, spare time, in the garage, whatever it might be. And it seems that you're all pretty keen to get those car parts and build your own cars, which is cool to see. I mean, it's why not make the most of this time, you know, downtime to work on your own cars and stuff like that in the garage. So it's really cool to see that. So it just means that we're super busy here at work, so we can't afford to take up too much hoist space or even take up too much time building the car. Yeah, we're gonna get stuck into it today and start cutting this front end off. So there's the old lock kit in there. You can get a bit of a better look at that. There are current stage 3 VRVS control arms in there. They are extended 75mm per side, so they're really quite wide. You sort of can't really, I suppose it's hard without the guards to understand how wide it is. But they sort of hang right out. A factory guard, those wheels hang right out of factory guard. So I assume that this was the transmission cooler for it at some stage, but these are a transmission cooler. You can get a decent size cooler on a factory Commodore. They do come on the factory Commodores on certain models and things. I'm not really entirely sure which model is which, but I do know that I think it's a VT Commodore, like a VT Auto. Not sure what years or if it was on all of them. Actually, I have a feeling it might be the ones that came with like a tow pack, so like a Hayman and Reese, like a larger tow bar and things like that. It was part of an upgrade as the 2100 kilo rated tow bar, that they'd also fit like a larger transmission cooler and things like that. But if you are building a car on a budget, like a drift car, and you are trying to keep costs relatively low, these make a really good power steering cooler, especially the slightly larger one that does come on those VT models and things like that. I mean, you can do it, the easiest way to do it would be to run it on your return line of your power steering setup, keep these fittings on it, basically just cut it off and slide your return line over, or, you know, run a new bit of return line and run some hose fittings like that, if you want to do it that way. What we do is that you can actually get a barbed fitting for this size thread. I don't know the part number off the top of my head, but you wind these out, and then you can just get it's like an AN style fitting that's barbed on one end. So you screw them straight in there, and then you can run your rubber hose onto that and put a couple of hose clamps on there. And that is the better way of doing it. That way you're not going to have issues with the rubber line popping off. But for something you can pick up the wreckers for, you know, probably a few bucks for something like that, absolutely near nothing. And they're a really good size, and they are designed to run like a transmission fluid through it, power steering transmission fluid through it. They cool it really efficiently. So, you know, to set that up. And then again, they usually come with these brackets, although they're very flimsy in sheet metal. They'll fit straight onto the front of the car. So it's really sort of quite easy to adapt that onto the front of the car. Run a bit of extra line through your return line and have that set up on there. Because we do get a lot of people that say, oh, you know, we're overheating power steering systems and pumps and things like that. What can we do? I'm on a budget. And a lot of people suggest or ask about the Astra power steering setup. But realistically, I mean, if you run a really, really good just transmission cooler, and depending on how it's geared, there's no reason why that won't work in 90% of setups. I mean,
here's all the front strip down, nothing left on it, just bare sort of framework. So we're gonna get stuck into cutting it off now. We've got things like, you can't just go ahead and chop things off and expect everything to work. We're gonna lose the bonnet latch and obviously all the mounts for the headlights and things like that. So we'll have to remake all that. The bonnet latch, we won't keep a bonnet latch, we're just gonna do hood pins. We'll still keep the hinge set up on the back, and we're having a look at doing a strut set up. So we'll do, we might be able to keep just like a, you know, standard style gas strut on it or something, which would be sort of really handy. But we'll have a look at possibly allowing the hinges to sort of over rotate and get the hood, the bonnet right up and out the road. So when you are working on it, you get plenty of access. You know, if you're working from back here and your heads are changed, you know, things like the rear plugs or check bar housing bolts or things like that, it's easy to get to and not have the bonnet coming up sort of, you know, through here. So, but yeah, for now, I'm just gonna hack it off through here and chop that off at that point through there, which you can actually see that's sort of where it's pretty much buckled from. This is all straight, but you can see it's buckled right on the edge here forwards. So we can chop that back off and get rebuilding on the new setup.
Shout out to Milwaukee for their hacksaw, because this thing is absolutely invaluable.
I'm trying to grow like the nose on Pinocchio. I can't lie, I'm close to an overdose. For my people doing time, let's propose a toast. I gotta blow now, y'all, I'ma go for broke, for real. Ex-friends looking sour, shows getting crowded and the crowd getting louder. Used to stay up late hours, really selling powder. Dirty ass kid, barely ever took a shower. I'm a grown man now, when I'm fresh and I'm clean. Smoke a little weed and I mess with the lean. I got a couple demons that be messing with me. The judge wanna throw away the key indefinitely. I can't smoke weed now, cause my PO tripping. Got a son on the way and his mother.
If work 8 hours after midnight, no breaks, no sleep, and it's all.
This tube's a 4130 chrome molly tube that we use. It's a light wall tube, which means it keeps the weight down, but it's also super strong. And we bend in our Speedworks bender, model 2 bender to a mandrel bender. So what that means is it causes no deformation through the bend, it keeps it all uniform. A lot of the cheap benders will, it'll ripple it up on the inside or squash the tube or spread the tube as it bends. So this is a really good bender for what we use. We built all our roll cages and things on here, all our suspension components, all the tubular components and stuff. We do a lot of bending with this one, so to do that, now I'm just going to measure the width of the rails and then put the other bend on the other side and then cut it to suit, and that'll make our front chassis on, you know, to add on to roll onto the front of what we're doing and we haven't cut off.
Over the grave, I get lost over the page. I'm in tune with my spirit, doing shrooms, trip for days. 18 with the blacks in the projects with the raps. White boy with the blacks from the sticks. I cross the tracks, rock and roll, rolling stone. Daddy left his pistol home, loaded up, shooting bottles off the porch to the songs. I was troubled, I was hurt, and it bubbled to the surface. Took it out on writing songs, put that seed up under the dirt. God gave me water, two sons and one daughter. Prayed and prayed harder, work hard and play harder. I visualized, put thumbtacks over outlines, and when they said I was out my mind, I put more goals in the pipeline. This is my time to get everything I wanted in this lifetime. I had to put my beliefs on the front line, and every song that I sing, it's always been you.
That wraps up for today's video. Sorry about the last little bit there. We did get these front bars on, but you didn't see that because the battery went flat on the phone and on the gimbal. But you can see we've got these front tubes on that will support the headlight tabs and things like that. So we're still yet to put a cross brace in there to tie it all in, but you can see that we've made a good bit of progress in a short amount of time. The lighting's also pretty terrible at the minute. But you can sort of see what's going on there. We've tied these front bars into the shut towers. We've got the lower section to mimic the chassis rail there. These front bars here will support the headlights, and then we're going to run a bar off there that will support the intercooler. We'll run the bonnet pins off of it. Down the track we'll make a bash bar that's going to be able to bolt onto the front, and the bash bar will be removable because that'll hold the bumper bar, or the bumper bar will be clipped onto that. And I want to be able to remove that because if we do have those frontal impacts, that's what's going to be damaged first. So that'll be the easiest to replace because we can just pull that off. That's about it. We've got that. We've got the front done. Got the rear done. Not many hours this weekend, but pretty happy with the progress overall. Pretty happy with what we've got done. That's it for now. Thanks for watching. I hope you guys are enjoying the build so far. If you are, hit subscribe and like the videos as you go. In the next one, we're going to finish off the front tube section. We'll get those little bits and pieces in there. We'll build all the tabs to hang the headlights and the guards and the intercooler and things like that. We'll hopefully start looking at doing the bash bars or the spigots we need to run them. And we're going to start welding a few bits and pieces, which I might even do during the week after hours off camera. See how I go. So that's it for now. Take care and enjoy.
This is what I was talking about when I said kids was going to be some life-changing shit. Bitches. Well, shout out Pittsburgh, man. Most dope. Big germ making me sound crispy and shit. Hey, yeah, I'm highly underestimated, so educated and getting paid quick. If you ever hated, anticipate that I'm famous. Got a bunch of bitches to sip on the champagne with. Celebrate it, we see in another day. Life good, never wanna end this.